Hello friends, this is Durga again from IIT Vasti, a one-stop shop to learn all the technologies. At this time, we are talking about HDP Certified Administrator Exam syllabus. And so far, we have covered everything related to installation. And also as part of the configuration, we have covered defining and deploying a rack topology script and changing the configuration of a service using Ambari. Now, we will try to understand how to configure the capacity scheduler. And the term scheduler in this context of configuring a capacity scheduler is to determine the way the jobs are submitted on the cluster. So there are three types of schedulers: FIFO, which is primarily for development purpose, which should not be used in production, and then fail scheduler, and then capacity scheduler. So capacity scheduler will try to understand the capacity on the cluster, and then it will try to determine how the concurrent jobs submitted by multiple applications in Hadoop ecosystem needs to be scheduled. Okay, so I will not delve into too many details about the topic. Overall, the capacity scheduler is a little bit complicated, but for the certification purpose, we just need to understand how to configure the capacity scheduler. We don't need to delve into the queues concept and all those things. So to get the documentation, just click on this link. And here there is a topic on capacity scheduler in Hortonworks documentation. And here they explain how to set up capacity scheduler manually by modifying the configuration files. So if you want to look at the configuration file, this is the location. And most importantly, the parameter on resource manager host has to be updated with appropriate property to point to the capacity scheduler. So in my case, you can go to Ambari and click on yarn and see which host is actually running the resource manager, and we have to log into that host. Okay, you can click on summary and you can see resource manager here. Click on the resource manager and you can see this is the IP address on which the resource manager is running. And if you look into my AWS console, our bastion is this one, 52.288.71 for public, and for private it's 172.31.53.37. So we need to log into the bastion server, and then using SSH forwarding concept, we have to connect to the 39. So first you need to make sure that the keys are added. The keys can be added on Mac or Linux by using this command ssh-add. It is little bit different when you are using Windows. It's better to use Sigwin, and it is already covered in another video, and I have already shown you the difference. If you are not sure, go to my YouTube channel, and in this go to the playlists. Click on this search button and search for SSH forwarding and hit enter. Okay, so this is the video which actually demonstrates how to do the SSH forwarding from the Windows laptop. This is for Mac and this is for Windows. So if you are using Windows, make sure you have Sigwin, and then you set up SSH forwarding, and you have to run command similar to this to add the key. Once that is done, you can run ssh-a -E2-user, which is the username and the public DNS of the bastion server. Once you are in, you have to run ssh ec2-user at IP 172.31.53.39 and hit enter. It will take you to the host on which resource manager is running. You can run this command called ps-fu. The username will be yarn, and you can see the resource manager running here, and also you can run ps. If you are not sure about the user, you can also run ps minus es grep resource manager to confirm that resource manager is running on this host. Okay, now if you go to etc hadoop conf, there is a file called yarnside.xml. So if you want to set up cluster manually, you have to update this file to change the configuration of the scheduler. So here I am searching for the scheduler. So this is the parameter which they are referring to as part of the documentation, and this one should be pointing to this to make sure that you are pointing to the capacity scheduler. If it is not already configured, then either it will be pointing to phase scheduler or FIFO scheduler. Okay, FIFO scheduler, it is highly unlikely that they give you as part of the certification exam. Most likely they might pre-configure with phase scheduler and they might ask you to change the capacity scheduler. They will not ask you to configure the phase scheduler for sure, because the certification is emphasizing on configuring the capacity scheduler. Okay, so you have to make sure the class name is correct. It's org.apache.hadoop.yarn.server.resource-manager.scheduler.capacity.capacity-scheduler. Okay, if most likely they will give this complete path. If they don't give, what you can do is you can come out of this and then search for, so you can run this command sudo find slash minus name star yarn star dot jar. It will give all the jar files which have yarn in them, and out of these many yarn you need to only focus on the Hadoop yarn. Under Hadoop yarn also there is a jar file with name resource manager in them, so Hadoop yarn server resource manager. So to narrow down the search, you can say yarn start resource manager star dot jar, and then it will give lots few jar files. And don't worry about UDI, Falcon and all those things, and also client. You just have to focus on Hadoop yarn. Okay, so now you can take this, and if the jar is accessible directly, you can run jar, but in this case jar is not accessible. So in my case JDK is installed. Here user JDK 64180_40 bin jar, and then you have to give the TVF. TVF will list all the classes in them, and you have to paste that jar file name, and then you after listing all the files, you have to search for grep minus I capacity scheduler dot class and hit enter. So you have to take this complete path and remove the slashes with the dots. So it will be org.apache.hadoop.yarn.server.resource-manager.scheduler.capacity.capacity-scheduler, and even if you go here, it's the same thing, org.apache.hadoop.yarn.server/resource-manager/scheduler/capacity/capacity-scheduler. So you can determine the path of the class file like this. Okay, make sure you run jar tvf command. If jar is not running properly, then you run this sudo find slash minus name jar, and it will give the path of that jar file. So here you can see this is the jar command I am using. I fetch it using find only, and then tvf is to list the files in the jar file, and then the jar file itself, and then I'm out piping the output of the jar tvf command to grep minus I, and I am trying to search for capacity scheduler dot class in it, and this is the one which have, and using this I can actually determine the path of the class name, and make sure you replace all the slashes with the dots when you define that. And then once you update this file, you have to run yarn rm admin or resource manager admin minus refresh queues, and then it will do the necessary tasks to make sure the capacity scheduler is changed. On top of that, you will have a capacity scheduler.xml file. Okay, under Hadoop slash etc Hadoop conf, there is a capacity scheduler XML file also. If you look at that file, it has all the parameters related to the capacity scheduler. So you can actually set the queues. So the concept start with queues. You have root queues and then you have sub queues, and you can define hierarchies for the queues. So if you want to get into the details, you can click on setting up queues. First it starts the details from root. In our case, the root is only default, and under default you can create the sub queues, but as part of the documentation, after root there are parent queues such as support, engineering and marketing, and then there are list queues. And if you have to set up manually, you have to follow this documentation. At root queues level, you have to give the queue names, root queue names, support, engineering, marketing, etc. And if you want to create the parent queues under support with name, training and services, you can you have to come up with name like this, yarn scheduler capacity. Instead of root, you need to give the name which is defined here. Like that, you need to give three names: capacity support, capacity engineering and capacity what is the third one, marketing. Okay, and then you can actually create the child queues as well. And then you can actually provide capacity for each queue. So that's the whole concept of capacity scheduler. You have the scheduler pointing to capacity scheduler, and then you can define the queues, and your jobs will be submitted as per the resources given to the queues. For the certification purpose, you don't need to get into the details. And also, as part of the certification exam, most likely you don't need to do manual enabling of capacity scheduler. They might ask you to provide Ambari. Even here, they didn't say whether it is Ambari or manual. So probably as part of the certification, they might ask you to configure the capacity scheduler. And for that, you can go to Ambari. Okay. And then click on Yarn. Click on Configs. And what is the parameter name? The parameter name is, the parameter which determines the scheduler is Yarn Resource Manager Scheduler class. And you can copy this one. And paste it in the filter. What happened? You can see that Yarn Resource Manager Scheduler class is already pointing to capacity scheduler. If not, just modify it if they ask you in the certification. And once it is modified, you have to click on save, and whatever services gets the circular orange arrows, you have to restart all those services to complete the restart and deployment of the configuration files if required. Okay, so that is how you can actually configure the capacity scheduler, both manual as well as using Ambari. That being said, I hope you are enjoying the content on the channel. If you like this video, please click on the like button. If you want to provide the feedback, please use the comment section of the video. If you want to discuss further about the certifications or big data, please join my LinkedIn group, ITversity-certifications or ITversity-big data. And finally, if you are not subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. You will get to see a lot more content like this over time. Thank you. Bye.